He knows a lot about the science stuff, Professor Dave Explains.
Hey guys, so for this practice problem, we have a few molecules and each has a pair of protons circled. And what we need to do is determine the relationship of these protons. We want to say whether they are homotopic, enantiotopic, diastereotopic, or heterotopic. And so if you didn't see my tutorial on these terms and their definitions, go ahead and check that out now. Otherwise, see what you can do. So let's take a look at this example first. Now, we remember when we're trying to assess the relationship between two protons, what we do is we redraw the molecule in two ways. And in each one of those two, we swap one of those hydrogens with some other element. And so we can take this one, and if we imagine drawing this molecule again, but with one of these hydrogens as, let's say, chlorine. Now, what we've done is we've definitely generated a new chiral center, right? And if we draw the other version, we can see that we would be generating the opposite stereochemistry at that chiral center. However, there is another chiral center over here, which maybe wasn't a chiral center before, but because of the chlorine here, this is now also a chiral center, and the chirality does not change in between, you know, between these two molecules. So these clearly have a diastereo. These are definitely two diastereomers. So these have a diastereotopic relationship. So we are going to say that these protons are diastereotopic. Okay. So because these two are diastereomers, they're diastereotopic. Now we're going to go over here, and we are going to say that for the same situation, let's draw, we can even just draw one of these, and we'll see what's going on. Let's say we replace the one on the wedge with, let's say, chlorine. Now, what we'll immediately notice is that we actually have not generated a chiral center, right, because of the symmetry of the molecule, right? These are not two different direction. So all we have to do is flip this on the other side, and we would get the other situation, right? These are actually the same molecule. We can just take this one, flip it on the other side, and we would get that. And so because these are the same molecule, these protons are homotopic, right? Same molecule. Those protons are homotopic. Now let's look at this one. We have this situation where we have a benzene ring, we have a bromine, we have bromobenzene, and we're looking at these two hydrogens. So let's draw what we would get. So we have the bromine here, and that's very important because let's say we change this to fluorine, right? Or we can change the other one to fluorine or something else. Doesn't matter what it would be. Now, these are clearly different structural isomers because these two have a meta relationship, whereas over here they have a para relationship. So they are structurally different. So these clearly have a heterotopic relationship. And then lastly, over here, we've got this situation. Now, notice that there is a pi bond here. That is very structurally significant because without this pi bond, we would just have this situation again, and certainly they'd be homotopic. But because of that pi bond, we are actually generating a chiral center. Right? Let's say we put a fluorine there. Versus a fluorine here. These are actually not the same molecule in the same way that those were. Because what we could do is we could take this molecule and we could flip it over and the fluorines would line up, but the pi bond would be on the other side of the molecule. So we are generating a chiral center. So we have one chiral center and it's the opposite stereochemistry at that one chiral center. So these are certainly enantiomers of one another. And for that reason, these protons have an enantiotopic relationship. So diastereotopic, homotopic, heterotopic, and enantiotopic. Thanks for watching, guys. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.